Hi, and welcome to this short demo about Database Workbench. In this demonstration, I will show you local filtering, sorting, and grouping of result sets. I connected to a database I use for multiple demonstrations. There's a customers table, an orders table, and I will create a query using the Visual Query Editor. Let's start the SQL Editor and then the Visual Query Builder. From here, I will drag onto the canvas tables for this query. Customers, orders, and as you can see, I will give them an alias. There you go. And you'll notice that there's an automatic join. This is based on foreign key definitions in the metadata of your database. Now, let's select columns. I want to see the order number, the order date, expected delivery date, and the time since the order was placed. For customers, I want to know some customer data and contact data. That's it. I can test the query by clicking the Run button, and the data is returned just fine. Let me click OK to accept the query, and it's in the SQL editor. Now I need to re-execute the query here to get the data. Let me expand the result set. Exit. By clicking the splitter here. And as you can see, this data is all over the place. There are some with a final order number and some without an order number. But there's no order in the result set. There's no order for company name, not for contact name, not for order date, not for anything. I can enable local sorting, grouping, and filtering by clicking the yellow area over here. There you go. All data is fetched in memory. And now I can use the filters and order the dataset by clicking the headers. Now there are quite some orders in this demo database, and this data was created using the advanced data generator. All the company names, first names for the contacts, etc. This is all fake data. Here you'll notice that order number is sorted. I can also add filters. Let's see, all non-blanks, for example. All the nils are filtered out. Alternatively, you can select all blanks. There you go, all the nils are black. I can use additional filters or grouping. If I drag a company the company name column header onto this area, all data is grouped and displayed in a tree. But there's more to be done. In addition to grouping, I can still use additional filters. If I want to filter on a specific company, I can select it from the available data. If I want to filter for all companies starting with the letter B, I'll have to enter it manually. And there you go. The condition is added to the filter panel, and the data itself is filtered. This is how local filtering, grouping, and sorting works. It's an easy way to find data in a large result set without having to modify the query itself. Thank you for watching.